As you all know, Apple no longer provide a charging adapter inside the box. And if you bought a new iPhone, your old iPhone chargers will not be compatible with the newer iPhones because they support the fast charging technology, which will only work with the new 20 watt chargers. So we all have this question, whether to go with the Apple original 20 watt charger or a third party charger without compromising on the phone safety and battery health. As a lot of people have a doubt that third party chargers might not be very safe and may affect the phone battery health in the long term. So all the third party chargers we have chosen here are on the basis of their top ratings and great reviews. And these products are from Anker, Photronics, and Dr. Waku. So let's first compare the design and build quality of all the chargers. They all are having almost similar height and similar width. And if I talk about the build quality here, Apple and Anker have slightly better build quality as compared to Photronics and Dr. Waku. Also, I would like to tell you, all these third-party USB-C power adapters support USB power delivery technology, which is the latest technology recommended by Apple to support fast charging. So let us start with our first test, that is the charging speed test. And here we have taken 4 iPhone 12s which are recently purchased and they all are at 100% battery health. So we have drained all these iPhone 12's battery completely to zero to perform this test. And we'll be using the original Apple cable which was provided in the box to charge all these iPhones. So now we have connected all these chargers to the respective iPhones and we'll be now starting the test. Now let's see which iPhone will boot up first. Here we can see almost all the iPhones were able to boot up almost in similar time, which is around 1 minute. So here we have kept all the iPhones in a similar settings and in airplane mode to get a more accurate result during the test. So now after 5 minutes you can see almost all iPhones are able to charge up to 10%, which is good enough for using the iPhone for a couple of hours. So let's quickly fast forward to 15 minutes into the test. And here you can see there's a slight more difference as Apple and Photronics reached 31%, followed by Anker at 30%, and Dr. Waku was at only 28%. So a good 15 minutes top up can actually be quite helpful, which can actually last for several hours. So now let's move on to 30 minutes and see how much charge do we get from each charger. And we can see here, Apple is slightly leading with a 58% charge, followed by Anker and Photronics just below by 1% at 57% charge, and Dr. Waku is still little behind at only 54% charge. So Apple in their website have claimed that you can charge your iPhone up to 50% battery in around 30 minutes. But here we can see it has actually performed much better, so that is actually quite good. So now let's quickly fast forward to 60 minutes and see how much each iPhone is charged. So here we can see Apple is still leading at 87% charge, followed by Anker just by 1% below at 86% charge, but Photronics and Dr. Waku is slightly behind at just 83% charge. So now let's check directly for 100% which charger finishes the first. So in most of the iPhones, optimized battery charging is enabled by default, which actually helps to preserve your battery health in a longer duration. So we can see here, Anker, which was just slightly behind the Apple, has finished the 100% charge the fastest in 1 hour 46 minutes, followed by Apple, which finished the charge in 1 hour 49 minutes, and here Photronics finished at 1 hour 52 minutes, and Dr. Waku finished the last, that is 1 hour 55 minutes. But here overall performance, I would say Apple performed the best because it charged the iPhone fastest till 50% and 80%. But after 80%, a slower charging is always better for your phone because it will preserve your battery health. We also performed the heat test for all the devices and the chargers at the interval of 30 minutes and 60 minutes. So here we can see at 30 minutes, iPhone temperature of Anker and Apple charger was slightly lower at 36 degrees Celsius, while the iPhone's temperature of Dr. Waku and Photronics was at 38 degrees Celsius. And when we did the charger heat test, all the third-party chargers, that is Dr. Waku, Photronics and Anker, crossed 45 degrees Celsius, which is very hot, and Apple maintained a very lower temperature, that is only 36 degrees Celsius. Then we did the same test at 60 minutes. But here also, Apple is the lowest at 29 degrees Celsius. And when we did the test for the chargers, Apple was still leading here as well at 30 degrees Celsius, and all other chargers were slightly cooler than before at around 35 to 40 degrees Celsius. So here we can see Apple has maintained the lowest temperature in terms of iPhone as well as the charger than any other third-party chargers, which definitely helps in maintaining the better battery health in a longer duration. So after my personal observations from all these tests, I would like to recommend the Apple charger as my first recommendation. Although it's slightly more expensive, but it is worth buying it as it charges your phone the fastest amongst all the chargers, and also it produces very less heat. So it will keep your phone battery health at the best. So if you're looking for a slightly more budget option, my second recommendation here would be Anker and Protonix chargers, as they also charge the iPhones quite fast without heating up the devices, although their chargers were slightly getting more heated up than the Apple charger. But as these both brands are quite well established and well known in the market for many years, these will be definitely more safer options than the other local brands which are available in the market. So thank you for now. I will see you in the next video.